Hey you guys, welcome back. I'm sorry for this morning face that I'm giving you here. I'm just not an early bird, you know, most people aren't, and I'm one of them. Today I'll be creating this look for Thanksgiving that I actually fell in love with. I mean, I just love the orange colors in general on how they pop on my eyes. You know, your girl's feeling herself on this look. So yeah, let's get started. Of course, I always start priming my lips. Then lately I've been using this brightening serum by Purelease. And it leaves my skin not just soft, but it brightens up my face and it reduces the dark spots on my face. It literally does what it says. And on the instructions, it tells me just to put very little, just dot a couple spots here and there. But I mean, you can't get enough of this product. I mean, if it's gonna do the job, keep it moisturized, give you that extra brightness on your face, give it life, give it some color, you know, have it even around. And make sure to tap in the product well, not rub it, tap it, because it helps it sit properly onto the skin. And once that's done, I apply my Kylie Skin Eye Serum under eyes and on my lids, because I mean, it's on your eye area, so I don't think there would be an issue applying that. Después, I'll be applying my Milk Blur Stick just to get those pores minimized and those fine lines, get it going. Then the eyebrows, which I have trouble identifying for some reason. Yeah, después, I do fill in my eyebrows. Once that one's done, sigo with the other eyebrow. Once I get them looking like bricks, I'll be going in with my Morphe M432. And I'll be using the concealer from L'Oreal that I've been using forever. And just cleaning out the brows, carving that shape out. Haciéndolos que se vean bonitos. The same, you know. Just like that saying, eyebrow sisters, not eyebrow twins. Once those eyebrows are set, I'll be moving on to the eyes. And for this look, I'll be using the 35G Bronze Goals Morphe Palette. And I'll be going in with this brown color called Record Temps. And I'll be going in with this angled brush and just focusing the color on the eyelids first. Then I work it towards the crease. And for more pigments, I just go back in with the same color over and over until I get that desired pigment on my eye. Once I get it looking like this, I'll be moving on to my other eye and I'll be doing the same thing. Once that color set, I'll be going in with this dark brown SPF and I'll be working it towards the outer corner of my eye and working the color out towards the top of my brow bone. Once that's set, I'll be moving on to my other eye and I'll be doing the same thing. Once this step is done, I'll be moving on to another darker color, more of a dark brown color, and I'll be applying it as well on the outer corner of my eye and working it out towards the brow bone. Oh yeah, and I forgot, the name of this color is called Heat Wave. Once that's complete, I'll be applying this glittery goldish color, which is kind of orangey, and I'll be applying it on my lid, but I'll be focusing it more towards the inner part of my eye. For more pigmentation, I feel like with the application of your finger, it gives it a more bright color. Sorry you guys, my dum-dum here was trying to remove this glitter off my under eye and not realizing that the finger that I used was the same one that I used to apply the glitter. Moving on from that disaster, I'll be marking my under eye to cover my dark circles perfectly using this orange colored pencil and then blending it out. And once that's set, I'll be moving on to my foundation from Tarte Shape Tape in medium sand, and I'll just be dotting it in. A sufficient amount, not a lot. A little bit goes a long way. I then just blend it out with this Real Techniques Beauty Blender. Also the ears. For the nose, I wanted to try another technique in applying more foundation to it because I feel like the product will last a little bit longer on the nose because usually that's the spot where it tends to rub off quickly. Moving on, I'll be using this lighter color from Tarte Shape Tape Light Medium Sand, and I'll be applying it under my eyes, on my forehead, and in my chin. Reason why I do this is because when you highlight these areas, it brings them out, especially when you contour. Once I let these areas bake, I'll be applying mascara Lash Princess from Essence. Like I've mentioned in the previous videos, if you haven't watched, go watch them after this. The reason why I don't apply falsies is because my lashes are naturally long, so just after coats and coats of mascara, they tend to look like false lashes. Once that's done, I'll be removing off the bake of my under eyes, my forehead, and my chin. With the same brush that I used to apply my eyeshadow, I'll be using it underneath my eyes and applying whatever was left of that eyeshadow and just applying it 3/4 of the way because I will be applying that same glitter I applied on my top eye. And this tiny bristled brush is the one that I'll be using to apply the same glow I applied on top of my eye. Once I'm done, I'll be applying mascara on my bottom lashes. I always hate this part because I always end up tearing up like this and it's not pretty because it'll ruin my makeup. After a couple minutes of eye burning and mental breakdown, I'll be getting back into my groove, working it out, knowing that I'm a champ for not ruining that makeup. With this clean angled brush, I'll be applying some bright color on the rocks onto the brow bone to enhance, make it pop a little bit. For the inner corner of my eyes, I'll be using this highlighter from Revolution, using this bullet looking like brush, and I'll be applying these two colors on my tear ducts just to bring out my eyes. Moving on to contour, I'll be using this Too Faced Milk Chocolate Bronzer. And out of strange curiosity, I wanted to see if this bronzer tasted like chocolate. And yep, it did taste like chocolate, weird enough. For application, I'll be using this angled brush. To blend out my contour, I'll be using this stippled brush and this Hoola Light Bronzer. And I go ahead and blend out the harsh contour. And I then contour my jawline with this Hoola bronzer. And you guys, this is my favorite part of doing makeup because once you contour that jawline, your neck seems to look a little bit longer and your face a little bit slimmer. And I'll be cleaning my contour with this Syat translucent powder. And for applicator, I'll be using this Morphe flat-ended beauty blender. And for powder, I'm not afraid of applying a lot of powder because this contour needs to look snatched right afterwards. While letting this bake, I'll be going in with my Ofra Madison Miller palette, applying blush with this brush in this nice rosy pink color, just tapping in the blush, not too harshly, but soft. For highlight, I'll be going in with this champagne color highlighter, and I'll be applying it to my cheeks and nose. And on top of my highlight, I'll be adding a little bit more blush just to settle the highlight in. Onto lips, I'll be outlining them with this Nutmeg Muscade Lip Liner, and I'll be applying the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream on top in the color Berlin. And for gloss, I'll be applying this Morphe Lip Gloss in the color Freebird. After this, I'll be going in with my Maybelline eyeliner and just enhance the nature of my beauty mark. And I'll be removing out the bake of my contour. And voila, I'm done.
once I look like a snack for the holidays.
I'll be giving it a quick glance just to make sure everything's copacetic. And once everything's set, my look will be complete. Si ustedes muchachas y muchachos liked my video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to keep on watching more videos from me, subscribe to my channel, guys. Love you.
Bye.